2016 Riel Community Committee Meeting. My name is Brian Mays. I'm the councillor for St. Vital. I'll be chairing tonight's meeting, joined by my colleagues Matt Allard, councillor for St. Boniface, and Janice Lutz, councillor for St. Norbert. So, South Winnipeg, St. Norbert. Still getting used to that. We're joined by staff from city clerks and planners. We have simultaneous translation available for those who may wish to address us en français. We have a relatively short agenda tonight. Madam Clerk, where do we need to hear delegations first, or do we need to pass minutes first?
Pass minutes first.
All right,
please.
So we'll have a motion to pass the minutes the previous meeting. So moved by Councillor Lukes. All those in favor?
Aye.
Contrary, that's carried. And straight through to delegations, Madam Clerk. All right, we don't need to waive rules. We're well organized tonight. All right, so we have two delegations just registered. You can speak for approximately 10 minutes. We may have questions. First up is Alexander Hood speaking to an item from Councillor Lukes' ward, though it's the St. Vital portion of Councillor Lukes' ward, the St. Mary's Road between Ward Avenue and Normand Avenue. There is Mr. Hood. Very good. If you can come down and give us your name and address at the mic here, and then you can address the committee.
Hi, I'm Alex Hood. I live at the Enclave on St. Mary's Road. And what else do you want to know about me?
Just you're here to speak to item 14, which Councillor Lukes has put forward, requesting a traffic study.
Yes. I wrote a couple of pages. I'd like to read it off. I feel more comfortable with it.
Sure.
Okay, councillors, I'm here to speak on behalf of all the Enclave citizens. They have all paid their dues through the years on on this earth. So to receive better treatment than to be restricted in crossing St. Mary's Road in a safe way. My wife has a handicap, so do others. I bought my wife a scooter, but we can't use it because we can't cross number one St. Mary's. There is an approximately 4-inch curb before Boulevard. Number two, the boulevard is wet or muddy. When all buildings on premises are built and occupied, there will be approximately 600 residents. Plus, when parking garage is clean, residents have to move their vehicles. The majority park their vehicles at the EMC 2005 parking lot across street. Then they cross street back to the apartment. Very unsafe for a lot of them because no crosswalk directly to Enclave from South St. Vital Trail. This trail was built many years ago and into St. Mary's Road. Doesn't make sense. Beyond what I have already said, I called 311 February, asked if an opening of snow ridge could be removed. They told me 4 to 5 days, gave me a reference number, took my phone number and name. 8 days went by, nothing got done. I called back, told me Public Works won't do it because it wasn't a crosswalk. Why didn't someone call me and tell me? Would have been a courteous call, and at least I'd understood where I was. That's when I called Councillor Lukes, Councillor Mays, and Mayor's office. Mayor's office referred me to Public Works Department, 986-5295, and I talked to Colleen. Colleen called me back. When Colleen called me, she said she was the community traffic engineer and what was my concern. I told her my concern, and she told me if the sidewalk did not continue right to the edge of St. Mary's Road, then it was a liability. I asked her what that meant. She couldn't answer. That's when I told her I am 75 plus. I shoveled the path. Am I liable if someone got hurt? She wouldn't answer my question. All she said, not to shovel it anymore. Is it because I'm liable? Or was she worried if I got a heart attack and died, city would be liable? Do I have to call Donald Trump in the U.S. and tell him the situation? Maybe he may suggest to build a 10-foot wall around our complex so we can't go out and go anywhere. because his way of thinking, we're going to die soon anyway. A lady in the summer fell across crossing the street, broke her glasses, and got badly hurt. This winter, a lady was trying to cross, and at the snow ridge, she slipped and hurt her hip. Drivers don't slow down. As a matter of fact, they speed up. All we're asking, cut the curb, about 2 meters of sidewalk and pedestrian cross signs, then Public Works has to clean this area. St. Anne's Road has a crosswalk with signs. Even if a person has to wait and cross when safe to do so. So this is my argument, and I would like to hear from City Council of what should I take back to my residents, because I know I could have got 200, maybe 300 petitions signed. I never had time for all that. And I know this is a concern, and what's a trail?
Thanks for coming down, Mr. Hood. Thank you. So I know that section very well. I know that pathway very well, the South St. Vitale pathway. In the last, I'd say, 10 years, maybe seven, that stretch of St. Mary's Road on the west side has grown dramatically, as you know, from like the Enclave all the way down to Ward Avenue. So the spot that you're speaking of to cross is in the middle of St. Mary's, and there would, exactly like you say, there need to be some curb cuts made to access it. That doesn't necessarily mean that when the snow removal comes, they will remove the snow, as that's how we first started talking about this, right? There was a bank there, and you couldn't get over it. So what I'm doing today is I'm asking that the department, the Public Works Department, do an assessment on where a crosswalk should go and if it is warranted or if it merits going, and to also look at curb cuts to that South St. Vitale Trail. A little further to the north of South St. Vitale Trail, you'll know there's that other pathway. It's kind of between two houses that goes in, and that one aligns very well to getting to Hentoliff Park, which, you know,
yes,
where the park is.
I understand.
So there's a lot of density and people on the west side, and there's fabulous trail system network on the other side to go to Dakota, to go to shopping, you know, what's all on the east side. So this motion here today is going to get the Public Works Department to analyze it and look at it in detail and come up with some recommendations on what to do. In that one particular location, my understanding is there's a guy wire. That's why they couldn't just scoop in there and clean that.
There is a guy wire, yes.
So that did that, because, you know, I talked to the Public Works Department and asked them if they could. Being mobile in the winter, being mobile at any time of year, being mobile and active is so important, and we've built all this infrastructure. We have all these people in condos and apartment blocks that want to get out and explore the neighborhood. This motion today is going to get the department to put some time and money into figuring out where the best crossing or potential crossing would be on that section where all those new dwellings are.
The thing is, this is when Colleen told me, she said, if there was a sidewalk right to St. Mary's Road, you know, extended right from the sidewalk that's there now, like there's about 2 meters.
Yeah.
She said then the city would have to clean it, regardless of what.
Yes.
Regardless
yes.
if there's a crossing or there's no crossing.
Right, but you're wanting to go across, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
So right now, you know, for the winter, especially, you know, for the winter, summer, you know, but it's muddy in the summertime. So
yeah.
It would be kind of nice to just be able to walk there without having to walk through water when it rains or...
Yep. They're going to look at all of that to improve the access, the mobility, the active walking in that neighborhood, in that stretch that we've identified.
Yeah, because I talked to a lot of clients there and stuff, and I just said, well, I'll represent them this time, and, you know, we'll go from there and see, you know, where we can go from here. Because, like I said, I could have got a petition of probably 200-300 people, you know.
You know what? I have to say all my colleagues are very, very enthusiastic about active transportation, but I have to say I think I might be one of the biggest champions down here at City Hall. And I'm glad. We Councillor Mays and I have been talking about a crosswalk. At one point, there was a study done to look at a potential bridge coming across from the university to somewhere on St. Mary's. So that area has been looked at with a magnifying glass from that perspective, and now with all this development on the west side, it's time we look at it, and I'm glad you've been the catalyst to bring this forward.
Well, I thought somebody had to start it because, you know what, like they say 50-plus, but really I think there's more 65-plus over there, and there's a lot of residents that would like to cross that street, you know, maybe going with walkers or maybe even with just canes.
Yeah.
Like, we got a scooter, where do we go? It's more dangerous going all the way around to the lights than if there was a crosswalk right across and be able to, you know, and get away from fumes and cars and noises, do we?
Yeah, no, I hear you. I hear you. I worked with Mr. Pereira, Fausto Pereira, who developed the Enclave on Pathways in St. Norbert. He developed another place in St. Norbert, condominium place. And he's very supportive of it, and I know we'll be speaking with him too. So, So thanks for being a champion on this.
Is my time up?
Your time is up. No, you have five more minutes, but we'll talk.
Two comments. I probably don't say enough how much a pleasure it is to have a counselor for St. Norbert who really gets the St. Vital part of the ward, so I appreciate that. Councillor Lukes really has a very good knowledge of the western part of St. Vital, which comes up against my ward. You also would be fair to say that we've added a non-lighted crosswalk at South St. Vital Trail at St. Anne's, which you'd mentioned. We added a lighted crosswalk, I think, credit with Councillor Lukes on this, we added a lighted crosswalk at South St. Vital Trail at Dakota, so what are we going to do at the west end? Would be a fair question.
Yeah.
I agree with Councillor Lukes. We probably should do something where exactly we should do it. I mean, I know we're talking about trying to get a bike trail from River, or AT path from River Gate, which is maybe half mile north of up to River Road.
Yeah.
Probably wouldn't be that far north. I'll leave it to the area councillor to sort it out. But there's a need for something. I don't know exactly where to put it in, but
we're checking. We've
knocked off the St. Anne's end. We knocked off the Dakota end. So it's only fair that we take a look at the St. Mary's end.
Thank you so much.
Thanks for coming down. Okay. Well, and we'll keep in touch with you. I know Bev's here, and we'll.
I'm not good at this, but I tried.
Wow, listen, you're a leader and a champion here, and you've got us moving on it. So that's good.
Thank you so much.
Okay. Thank you.
And now for Stéphane Dorge, who's here to talk about functional design study for Provencher Boulevard. Is this on our agenda?
No.
Is this on the agenda? I'm good with that.
Good afternoon. So I'm not sure.
Sure you don't already have a functional design. I'm just kidding. I was just going to say, pour ton information, on a les services d'interprétation. Si tu préfères parler en français, mes collègues vont pouvoir te comprendre parce que.
Absolutely.
Ryan parle français. Puis,
some might slip in, but I'm very comfortable in both. So.
Fire away.
Perfect. Well, thanks for hearing me again related to the Protected Bike Lane project on Provencher. I've been working hard to gather community support for the project. I know that other members of our St. Boniface Residents Association have been advocating related to a traffic study related to the trucking route on Provencher Boulevard. And I know that this functional design study for Provencher Boulevard would definitely complement that traffic study. So I'm hoping that with the 35 on page 5, the 34 organizations that support the project, we can make a request to Public Works to do a functional design study for the implementation of the protected bike lanes.
Councillor Lukes, as the chair of Public Works, would you have some advice as to how to proceed? Would you want to have a motion to Public Works?
Yeah, you know what? I think, Stefan, this is fantastic to see all this. I think probably the best route would be to make a motion. I can make the motion, or it's your word.
I can make the motion for Public Works to consider.
And it'll come to our committee on the 14th? and it'll come to our committee. And just to give you insight to the process, what will happen is it will be referred to the department to be considered in their 2017 action plan, because the 2016 action plan, everything works like a year ahead here at City Hall. So if you want to make that motion,
sure.
Then it comes to the committee, and then it's like it's the official into the system.
So,
what was that? So just hold on here one
they're second. Asking for functional design.
What was that motion we made last time?
So the motion that passed last time, or that the committee concurred with, was that it would be considered in all future pedestrian and cycling consultations for the respective area.
So this is specific then to the action plan. We'll put the 2017 action plan. Sure.
Correct.
So I would move the functional design then for Provincial Bike Lanes for consideration into the 2017 action plan by administration.
Yeah, and then they will consider it. They will look at their other projects. They will look at roadworks. They will look at all that, and they will consider it. And then when they come out with their 2017 action plan, you know, it'll have been considered. It may or may not be in it, but it gets it. It's the formal movement.
It'll provide the report and the community support for it.
Yes, yes. Perfect.
Okay, well, so moved.
Well,
okay.
Just before you move that, I had one question, which I think is directed to Stefan, which is,
absolutely.
Is there, I'd like some consideration. I don't want this to all go ahead, and then the issue that's being looked at in my ward further south, one of the things that's being looked at is some sort of bike express route, some bike highway. I've suggested that Des Mirons be looked at as a possible option for that, as opposed to maybe St. Anne's, St. Mary's. Just, I mean, in some ways it might benefit Councillor Allard's ward more than mine, but you can see you can come off the Fermor Bridge and make a right on a bike and
correct.
Figure downtown on Des Mirons.
From Fermor, you mean inward.
Right, you can't do that on with a car. So it's a completely crazy idea. I would submit, and the street widens out at some point, but that would eventually get to Provence. Is there any thought about in what you're looking at along Provence? There's something that would disqualify linking up with Des Mirons at some point.
Not at all. It would complement it. If you're looking at Des Mirons, you're then connecting to Des Mirons at Provence, and then you would be able to get to downtown from that connection at that intersection.
Yeah, that it seems to maybe even, you know, hang together, that there would be something if you're coming from Windsor Park or Southdale or the eastern part of my ward that you could come up, might be better to come up that way than along St. Mary's.
St. Mary's and St. Anne's is definitely more direct to the downtown core.
Sure.
But as an additional resource to get people in that direction, absolutely. It's both would complement one another. I would love to see one down St. Anne's, St. Mary's and Mirons, but.
Okay, that was my question.
Okay, all right.
So Councillor Allard has moved.
Made the motion.
Sorry, so the motion is to move that the functional design study be considered for the 2017 action plan.
That a functional design study be considered. Because, this is just support.
Yeah, design support, study be considered for the 2017 action plan and forwarded to the Standing Policy Committee on
Active Transportation Action Plan. The 2017 Active Transportation Action Plan.
Action Plan. Okay.
Yes.
Should you write it by one street?
For
the Provence, the idea of the protected Provence bike lane.
Sorry?
For the idea of the protected Provence bike lane.
Protected Provence bike lane.
Stefan, you're aware that the current strategy plans for a different route, the route down.
Well, the current pedestrian cycling strategy route is the parallel route, which is a neighborhood greenway down Notre Dame.
Yeah.
Which again defeats the Esplanade Riel connection that we're trying to complete. So within the report, it talks about the connections that already exist to Provence Boulevard, and that's creating a bikeway that would go directly from the legislative building down Assiniboine through the forks to Esplanade Riel, and then from Espinatriel continued on Provencher Boulevard to Des Mirons, where we could better emphasize the connection to the pedestrian bridge over the Seine River connecting to Mission Archibald. And there's currently an RFP out for a connection from Archibald and Mission to connect to Northeast Pioneer Greenway. Mm-hmm. Because detouring away from all of our community services, our, you know, Collège Royal is on Provencher Boulevard. The, you know, all the services that the community wants to attract people to is on Provencher and not on the secondary route. So it only makes sense that we would prioritize development of a dedicated cycling infrastructure on Provencher Boulevard.
Right. Well, I just wanted to, bring that to your attention here.
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay. So, Rochelle, was that good for motion?
Yep.
No one. So moved.
All right. All those in favor?
Aye.
Contrary? That's
yep. Thanks, Stephen. So that motion will go to Public Works for consideration at that Standing Policy Committee on which date?
It goes on the 14th, and then we refer it on. So,
to administration.
You don't have to come. It's going to be like a 7-hour marathon day. You're more than welcome to come if you want, but
great sales pitch.
But that will go on.
Would this report go with that motion as support for it?
Yep. If you have it electronically, is it? You know what? They can scan it and make it electronic, right?
I've submitted it electronically. I can send it again. Not a problem by PDF.
If you could send it again, please, just in case.
Not a problem. I have all those different endorsement letters digitally.
Thanks. I know the amount of work this takes. Thank you.
Yeah,
I will keep gathering more and more.
Merci, Stéphane. How's the new baby?
Léon's doing quite well, thanks.
Yeah. Appreciate it. Are you getting any sleep at night?
I am. It's Lucille that's struggling.
Oh, okay. Congratulations.
I don't know how you ran with your newborn. That would
he
have
was
been
born
a tough election.
After.
He
was it just
anyway.
After?
But I don't sleep. There's too many reports to read anyway.
Perfect.
Stéphane, I actually have the report, so it's all good.
Okay, perfect.
Thanks, Stéphane.
Thank you.
No further delegations, Madam Clerk? If not, on we roll to the reports. I'll hand the chair perhaps to Councillor Lukes for item number one, because I think that might be something from Councillor Allard and from me. But je voudrais appuyer un octroi pour Soccer Franco Fund, $225.
$225?
Oui. And are you in?
Do I have the same application?
Or is it they asked for $450 this year for it?
Oh yeah, so I'd like to match that.
Sounds good.
Yeah.
Okay. All in favor?
Aye.
Carried.
Yeah, we've got our bilingual component in for tonight. Item number two is your ward, Councillor Lukes.
Sure. I'd like to make a motion to support the Manitoba Great Wall of Performing Arts to assist with the cost of their never-ending Chinese New Year celebrations.
All right.
Sorry, and that was for how much?
$300. Yeah.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Contrary? Carried. I'll hand the chair over. I think there's a misprint. I don't think they got $500 last year, but I'll move $200 for New Beginnings Church out of the St. Vital Ward. Allocation.
Okay.
Yeah.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Carried.
Sorry, forgive me. Well, you're okay with not?
No, I don't know. Whoever.
Oh, I'm fine.
Yeah. Sorry. Number four is still, I'll hand the chair over to Councillor Lukes then. I'm going to put in, I'm going to lay this over one more month, I think. Sort that out. So I'll just lay this over to the April meeting.
Okay. All in favor?
Aye.
Carried.
Okay. Number five, we're on to community incentive grants. Ooh. I believe this is St. Boniface Ward, Centre de Renouveau Alno.
Okay. On, I don't know if I can do omnibus, but for the CIGP for St. Boniface, I guess my intention had been to move them to for when the new allocation would be available. I understand it's not yet available, but there is one that I understand is pressing, which is Norwood.
Okay.
So I wonder if it's possible just to move the $20,000. I think it's $20,000 that they're asking for. Just a sec.
Sorry, so you want to lay over all the other communities?
All but Norwood, because I understand they need their funding right away.
Okay.
So that's some other funding applications.
So that's 5, 6... and 9 get laid over.
Right, I'm just trying to find.
Okay.
Okay, and then for number seven, you are approving 20,000.
So is it 20 that there? I'm just trying to find that.
So we'll vote first to lay over.
Four, five, six. No. Oh, no, sorry. Five, six, nine.
5, 6, 9, yes.
Right.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Okay, and then Norwood, I've got it now.
And then, yes. Then
so they were looking for 20. I would like to move $20,000 to support this very important project in the community that has some other funding already lined up that where they need the funding from the partners in order for this project to be successful. So, so moved.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Aye. Contrary, that's carried. Councillor Lukes, this one was in, was this one from last week?
Yes, and you know what, if it's possible that we couldn't meet, but can I lay it over till
April?
April,
sure.
Yes.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Contrary, carried. I suspect number 10 is Councillor Allard's ward, Mazenod Road and Ray Marius Road.
Right, I don't. Oh, I had someone who I thought was coming in for a delegation, but perhaps not.
We're here for delegation if you have questions.
Oh, did you want to talk about what you're did you want to maybe present the report, or who is it?
The school has written the report.
Right.
I, on behalf of the city,
will take
it. Yeah.
Okay, I see. Oh, yes, I recall. You know, I think the question, I'm sorry the resident's not here anymore. I think they had a question about whether or not the road could be extended further. Is there any time sensitivity to this report?
Yes.
There is? Okay.
Do you want to come down?
So I'm Jody. I'm with the Real Estate Division, and I applied for the opening application. And this is Mike, and he can give you the particulars about the servicing if you have any questions, and Bo is the author of the report.
Okay. Well, I guess the resident that I had briefly spoken to was asking about, I guess, potentially extending the road even further, but...
Well,
you're saying there's some time sensitivity. Is there any harm in laying this over till next month so that I can check in with our resident? Or?
Well, we need to facilitate the development of Parmalat, so that's why we're applying for this opening, and that's critical. So if I don't know where they were thinking of extending it,
right.
Was it to the western end?
You know, it was. I just bumped into someone. His name's Réal Rioux from. I guess he's a stakeholder in the old St. Boniface neighborhood, and I guess he had something to say, but he's not here anymore. So, would like to hear what he has to say. What happens if this is laid over till next month? I guess is my question.
You speak to that,
Councillor Allard. I'm Mike Scholney. I'm looking after the servicing for Parmalat.
Mm-hmm.
We have. I guess construction contracts that are about to be awarded, and the contractor that is installing the municipal underground services, which are the water mains, wastewater, sewers, et cetera, needs the open right-of-way east of Mazenod Road up to Ray Marius Road. We need that water main to supply water with sufficient pressure and for firefighting flow to the Parmalat site. And the construction contracts will probably be awarded in the next week or so, and the contractor will be starting kind of immediately thereafter. I'm wondering whether the resident that you speak of is talking about the stub that's been left west of Mazenod Road. The previous application that had been filed by Terracon Developments had that roadway extended to the far west boundary of the city property. We've cut it off at the where it's shown on the current application because the disposition of that roadway relative to how it interfaces with the adjoining properties, which are privately held, haven't been fully resolved. And I guess it's the intention of the Planning, Property, and Development Department through the Real Estate Division there to review what options they have relative to that roadway, because it really should be coordinated with the adjoining properties to facilitate an ultimate roadway pattern.
Right.
And so so it's just been basically terminated at the westerly boundary of Parmalat's lot, just to allow us to put servicing into that section if it's required.
Okay. I think, I'm understanding that there's some urgency to this, and seeing the resident not here, he must have had to go to another engagement. I think those are all my questions for now.
Thank you.
Just to let you know that this will not go until next month's P&D agenda, because P&D meets tomorrow. So just in case.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, sure.
So for that.
But then if I lead it over, then it would be sort of.
They'd have to come back here, and then they would probably have missed P&D for the next one.
For the next one as well?
Yeah. Sorry, our meeting. My computer just.
I guess I'm just thinking if there's no actual benefit to the schedule, then maybe I would lay it over to check in with this resident.
Sorry, let me just double check that. My computer is disconnected, so I need to double check.
Yeah, I don't know when the next P&D meeting is, but it would be, it's.
Because our meeting is April
4th. Ours is April 4th. And when's the next P&D meeting?
Sorry, that's what I'm looking at right working. Now.
Okay, I'll look it up.
Okay, great. So it's not just.
Yeah, so all the computers are down.
Yeah. They're all down.
Something.
P&D
is the bit. So it wouldn't make it then as well. Okay. So I've got to move this now for it to make the P&D agenda next month.
Yes.
Okay. That being said, I'd like to move the public service recommendation.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Contrary? Carry.
I no longer have an agenda on my screen, so I'm going to look off Councillor Ellard.
One second.
One with land dedication.
Letter case, okay, I'll hand the chair to Councillor Ellard. I'll move the recommendation for the. No, sorry, it's Councillor Luke's. Is it, where are we?
Sorry.
Glenwood Community Center. Was it
Sorry. Glenwood I got Community the. Center. I'm back on the. Okay. Report prior.
Yeah.
Okay, there we go. What did I freeze too?
Yeah.
Yeah, everybody did.
Oh, there you go. Okay, there's too much budget going on.
Okay, I'll move the recommended amount of.
The recommended amount that was on there for Glenwood.
Whatever it is, $8,000 something for Glenwood Community Center.
Okay, all in favor?
Aye. All right.
Carried.
Then we've got.
Plan approval, Park West.
Plan approval, Park West.
The one in the middle?
No, we haven't. It's the whole city website.
Pedestrian
is
just
dense. One's mine.
Oh, yeah, sorry. One's your portion. Sure.
Good thing I've got a printer report. You don't have to rely on computers.
Now. Leave the digital economy alone.
That's true. That seems to be working on the of St. Boniface, St. Vital.
Okay.
For the Greenbelt.
Okay, I'd like to make a motion to receive the report as per the recommendation of the department.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Contrary, that's carried. I hand the chair back to Councillor Allard. I'll move item number 12, a request from a resident in my ward for a look at, now that I think about it, this actually would connect to Councillor Luke's ward.
Yes. And, hit me up for the money.
I should have thought of that. In any event, a request for a traffic study to look at this particular currently unlighted crosswalk to see if there's a need to change it to a lighted corridor.
All in favor?
Aye.
Contrary, carried.
Carried. Okay. Sorry. And
approving that?
Yeah.
Yep.
Okay.
Yeah, we're moving it to Public Works, and same with
similarly.
Okay. You know, I've called. Maybe it's not a traffic study. I mean, it isn't a traffic study per se. It's looking at a pedestrian corridor is what it's looking at. So. Should I think maybe change the wording of it from a traffic study? It's like studying where the pedestrian corridor would best be located.
Sure. Yep. Okay.
Okay. So,
I can, I'll rephrase it.
Okay.
When I'm able to see it.
The title of it or whatever. The title maybe. Okay. Okay. I'd like to move this on to the Public Works Committee.
Is Norman, I don't know that part of you, is Norman?
Norman Park.
Right.
It's kind of at the end of St. Mary's. It's kind of on the last turn, the residential Norman Park development.
Isn't the enclave?
Yes, and so we're going between War.
It goes north.
No, it was Vista I had on there.
Yeah.
Between Vista and Norman, not Ward.
That would hang together.
Yeah. So, Rochelle, it's between Vista and Norman.
Okay.
From Vista, like River Road.
Right.
From
south. So, basically, from Vista south to Norman Avenue.
So okay.
Traffic pedestrian corridor on St. Mary's Road between it's Vista and River Road and Norman Avenue.
Okay, so not Ward.
No.
Okay.
I don't know where that came from.
Okay.
Okay.
Sounds good.
All those in favor?
Right. Aye.
Aye.
Aye. Good motion there. Aye. I have two per capitas. Do I need to suspend the rules?
Yes, please.
All those
do you want me in the chair?
Sure. Or something? Move to suspend the rules. Consider two per capita grant.
All in favor?
Aye.
Contrary, carried.
First is, I think Councillor Allard is going to match me on this, $250 for the Greendale. Spelled like it sounds. Greendale Falcons football team.
Councillor Luce, would you like to take a chair?
Sure.
You're matching?
Sure. Yes.
So I would. I mean, you've moved a motion,
yep.
Councillor Mays.
This is an odd.
I'd like to match the funds as well.
Very good.
Okay.
So $250 from both of you. $250.
Yep.
Okay. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Contrary. Carried.
And I will move $161 for the Rotary Club of St. Boniface, St. Vital for their career symposium.
Okay. All in favor?
Aye.
Contrary? Aye. Carried.
Any further business?
No, I have none. You, Councillor Allard, have anything?
Surprisingly not.
Whoa. All right.
Okay.
So,
all right.
Motion to adjourn. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Thank you.
Period.
Court, Steve. Second, please.